The Holy Book says, teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. That is the story of Tinu Shenuga as she celebrates 40 years in the land of the living. There are definitely things to be grateful for the past 40 years. That is why she has put up 4 hours of praise with friends and family to thank God for all that He has been to her. I am very sure there are friends and family who have a lot to say about her. So you just come along with us as we hear what they have to say. Hello sir, how are you?
Wow, I'm fine.
It's always good seeing you, know, full of energy, full of life. Can we meet you, sir?
My name is Oluwalomi.
Oluwalomi, busy. You need to go and check that person out online. He's really doing so much for God. So, what's your relationship with that celebrity today, sir?
Yeah, father, I'm meeting this Shenuga. She's my friend. We are very close. I was involved in her album. While she was recording, she father and I was in the studio. We were putting one or two hairs together. And I believe she's a gift and a blessing to the body. That's why we came all the way to celebrate. I had a very, very tight schedule this weekend. But I said, if I'm not here, I will not be anywhere else. I must come and celebrate with my friend.
Now that she's turning 40 or celebrating her 40th year, what would be your advice to her?
Well, commitment to God, dedication to God's service. She should continue to be a nice person that she used to be. She should continue to appreciate people like she used to do.
Hello sir, how are you?
I'm good.
Please, can you introduce yourself? Let's know you.
My name is Eljo Onoja and I'm glad to be with you today.
Wow, wow, wow. So tell me, Eljo, what's your relationship with the celebrant of today?
Ah, Chinu is my friend. She's like a sister to me. And then we're all together building the Abeokuta Fellowship of Music Ministers. She's a great singer, she's my sister, she's my friend, and I need her to be here.
No, nah, no be today. I knew her as far back as 9 years and 10 years from now, and I know her to be an interpreter, as somebody said inside. And but to the glory of God, God found her, God called her, and thank God she responded to the call of God. Okay. And now she's doing wonderfully well to the glory of God.
Wow. Did you hear that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, 6, 7, 8, 9 years.
Yes.
And imagine how God can turn the life of someone around in 9 years. What are the things you think you could chip in as an advice for her as she runs ahead of these 40 years?
Oh well, Tinu, for me, keep moving, keep pushing, keep pressing. I always tell you that the top, there are no special people reserved for the top. So, and there's space in the top for every one of us. So keep pressing. It's 40. It's not the end. Neither is it. They say life starts at 40.
Yeah,
but that's not true. Tinu's life started a long time ago. And she's been living it. She's been making impact. I just want to let you know that I celebrate you. I love you. Just keep doing what you're doing for God. And I know God will keep blessing you and promoting you to the world.
She should just keep worshiping the Lord. And the Lord will keep increasing her on every side.
She's an amazing person. I have to say that she's a life of a place. She's a warm and a pleasant person. And my advice for her on a day like this, that she's marking her 40th year birthday, I want to say that this is just the beginning. God is about to take her to a greater place that she could ever imagine. Stay humble, stay connected to God, and He will see you through. God bless you.
There is a saying that goes that behind every successful woman, there is a successful man. And we have here with us the husband of our celebrant. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, thank you.
She's celebrating 40 years. How long have you been married, sir?
We've been married for 13 years.
Wow, wow, wow. So what can you say about this whole journey for the past 13 years?
The journey has been good. There has been the Lord that has been on our side. The Lord has been faithful. He has been good to us. He has kept the marriage. In fact, I'm blessed to have married her. I'm appreciating God for this.
All right. Now we've had asked people about their opinion and we've heard quite a number of things, but I know that no one would know as much as you do, sir. So what are the challenging times that you've had and you knew that it could only have been God all through this journey, sir?
There are many challenging times, but above all, the Lord has been faithful. I remember there was a time that it seems as if I had no job, but the Lord supported us. even my wife by my side, the Lord has been really, really faithful to us. The Lord has really helped us to put through the hard times. Really bless God.
Now that she's starting life, they say life starts at 40. Now that she's starting life afresh at 40, what is your candid advice to your wife?
My candid advice to her as she's starting a new life is that she should hold on to God and keep trusting God, keep believing God. She should never look back. The Lord that has been with her all these years is still the same today and today, the same yesterday and tomorrow. So I would advise her to hold on to the Lord and serve Him the more. And I see the Lord taking her to higher heights in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate you coming. Okay. Happy birthday once again.
Thank you.
Now, everyone has been hearing Mrs. Tinu Shenuga. Can we meet you, ma'am?
This is me, Tinu Shenuga, aka Chef Adam.
Chef Adam. So, what has the father done over the 4 years?
Unspeakable things. Things I can't measure with words. I think that's the best way. That's the best way I can express it. What I can't express with words has this to my father done in this 40 years.
Now, for the past 40 years, I'm sure there have been down times, up times. Through those moments, can you just share with us what your experience has been like?
The Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord deliver him from it all. So I won't mention them because I've had deliverances from them all, one after the other, back to back. The deliverance have been coming back to back. Let me give you an example. A week to my 40th birthday, my 40th birthday is November 17th. Exactly a week, we had a family function in Ibadan. I was in the car with my sister and her son and the photographers who did my photo shoots. And just at our back, the trailer that was coming in had lost brakes. We had rolled up the glass, the AC was on, music was on, we were gisting. People were shouting on the road, trying to let us know what had happened. We didn't know anything. But to the glory of this God that I serve, the trailer just got a space just before the car, towards the side of the road. You know, that place is where we are naturally supposed to tilt to. And we say, I just have some trailer in London. If we had known that is happening. But because we did not know, we were going on the road, the trailer tilted to one side, and then, of course, the car was damaged, but there was no drop of blood that was lost. So that's a week to my birthday. It is happening, it happens back to back, and I get the deliverance back to back.
You know, man, they say that life starts at 40. So I believe by God's grace, there will be another 40 years.
Amen.
So what are your plans for the years ahead?
So now, I didn't have plans, as to say plans, that this is what I want to do. I live like the spirit. I live like the wind. I go to wherever the spirit leads me. I do whatever the spirit asks me to do. So I have left it all to God. I believe that He who has seen me through till now, He's going to continue to see me through. My plans are in His hands. As He unfolds it to me, as He says to me, you know, this is what I want you to do next, that is what I will do.
Many people would have their 40th birthday and they will invite friends and family to parties. But you're here organizing 4 hours of solid praise. What is behind it?
Praise God. Like I have said, it is what God wants. It is what He wants me to do. I can organize a party very easy. This one is tedious to organize. Yes, it's tedious. But that is what He wants. He wants me to give Him 4 hours of solid praise, and that's what I'm going to do. And that is what I am doing. Now that is why we are here today. And it pleases me. Whatever pleases my Father in heaven pleases me.
There are young chaps out there who are yet to turn 40. What would be your advice to them over there?
Well, my advice to you young chaps who are yet to turn 40. First of all, give your life to Jesus. That is the number one advice. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. I was not like this before. He made my life beautiful. And so He's going to do that for you too. Just do that. That is the foundation. Every other thing is going to keep building on it.
Well, you've heard that. As God becomes your foundation, every other thing would fall in place. So we'd like you to just give us a little song before you go.
Hey, my signature song. Show mo tu mo inonjo igbe orun ara ise father mi lo je iyan gbe ile to farahan lori okun ara ise father mi lo je.